Hey everyone, so my name is Adrian. I'm the CEO of Remax in Southern Africa, and I was asked to talk to you a little bit about buying, you know, the steps to buying, the good, the bad, and the ugly. So let's unpack that just a little bit so we can park the bad and the ugly to one side and you can have a great experience when purchasing your home. So for me, it starts with why. Why are you doing it? Why are you wanting to get into this? And I think it's a deep-rooted question, but one that you and your spouse and family should really answer. You know, is it because, like for Vicky and I in our previous home, we wanted to buy this particular home because it was within 500 meters of a school that we wanted to send our kids to. So we were planning in advance. They were still lighties, and we wanted to send them to this particular school because the school had a great name and great education and good principals and so forth. So that was our reason, but it may not be your reason. In fact, we've subsequently moved because now that the kids are older, you know, we wanted a little bit more elbow room and the distance to school wasn't as important for us. But for you, it may be completely different. Maybe it's transport related. Maybe you need an apartment and not a house that has got all the high-tech stuff in it, right? Wi-Fi and fiber and all sorts, and, you know, fridges that order food on its own, whatever it is for you, okay? So, maybe you're just starting out, and maybe you don't have a kid yet, but you got a Jack Russell, and you know Jack Russells need space, they got lots of energy. So anyway, I guess what I'm saying is that each of you has different reasons. So identify what those are so that when you start the search process, you start searching for something that makes sense to the needs that you're looking for. And in these times we find ourselves in right now, in Corona, it's going to be interesting to see what the purchasing patterns look like over the next 18 months. I mean, already you're having people move out of the urban areas, like the metro areas, more into suburbia because a lot of people are working from home and may continue to work from home for 75% of the time. So again, first determine why it is you're doing what you're doing. So here's the thing, and a real estate agent will always tell you when asked the question, when's the right time to buy, they'll always say now. And I can tell you that that's the wrong answer, because the best time to buy a home is always 5 years ago. I mean, that's how this game works. It works in cycles. You have highs and lows. In 2008, we had a financial crash and there was a bit of a dip. And then the market picked up again, and now we have a pandemic, and who knows where the curve is going to bounce or whether it's going to dip. But I can tell you that it operates in waves. But those waves continue to operate in an upward trend. So over a period of time, you will net a good return if you make a sound investment and if you buy smart. And I guess that's what we're talking about here. How do I know that? History shows it. History shows from 95 to 2015, an average house price that had increased. And yes, while there are little, in fact, there aren't many dips here. But while if you had to zoom in to one or 2 years, you'll see a couple of little dips. Again, I spoke about 2008. There was a little dip. But over an extended period of time, buying a home and owning a home will net you a return. And in our current environment that we find ourselves in now, for many, it's become affordable to buy a home. In fact, even more affordable to purchase a home than to rent. With interest rates having come down significantly over the last just few months and certainly over the last couple of years, I would definitely start looking at whether this is something you want to participate in and get your foot in the game, get your foot in the door rather. So let's talk about some of the steps to buying your first home. And I'm going to run through these with you, and hopefully you make some notes and you can pick up some tips. If it's too quick for you, I'm sure you can replay this later when they make it available. Or otherwise, hop onto our Remax website, go to ask.remax.co.za, and you can find all sorts of information on there, or ask us some questions and we'll engage with you directly. But steps to buying your first home. One, and I'll definitely start with this one. What can I afford? Okay. Two, the search when you start looking for the actual property. Three, using a trusted advisor and why that's important. Then making the offer and how to go about that and how to put yourself in a position of strength. Five, show me the money. In other words, you're going to have to go and get the loan. Okay, what's the best way to approach that? And then six, yay, everything's sorted and it's moving day. Although that has its stresses as well, so maybe I'll have one or two tips for you on that. So let's start at the beginning. Step one, what can I afford? Now it has to start there, because what you don't want to do is go through the search process and go through the motions and find what in your mind is a dream home and then find out that you can't afford it. And I mean that in the nicest way. What I mean by that is the bank isn't willing to loan you an amount based on your profile. So I would start with this, okay? You can hop onto some websites. We use an originator at the bottom of the slide. You'll see Better Bond. They can help to get you pre-qualified, or you can just hop on their website and go and fill in the affordability calculator. It's a very simplistic calculator, but it'll give you an idea of what the banks will be willing to lend you from a home loan perspective. If you want a more accurate estimate, engage with Better Bond. It's a free service, by the way. They don't charge for any of this. Even when you get the home loan, they don't charge for it, okay, at all. So it's a free service, and I would recommend you do it. Because when you have that pre-qualification, what a pre-qualification means is that you can take your offer to a seller confidently, knowing that as soon as you thereafter go and apply at the bank for a loan, it's a 99.9% chance that that loan is going to be granted. Now imagine the confidence that you'll have when making that offer in front of the seller. You'll also put yourself at the front of the queue with respect to all the other buyers, assuming of course that there isn't someone else offering a cash offer. So step one, determine what it is you can afford. Use a bond originator to help you to get a pre-qualification. In this market right now, more than 50% of home purchases right now are first-time buyers. Do not miss this opportunity that exists at the moment. Step two, search. Well, eventually you've got to go and look for the property, right? And where are you going to start? You're going to start in the newspapers. No, you're not. You're not going to start in the newspaper. Let me tell you, those days are gone. Okay? By the time one of our agents or any agents advertise in the newspaper, that property is already at least a week, if not older. Okay? And many of these properties are a lot older than that. There's no ways that RE/MAX can put its 58,000 listings in the newspaper week in, week out. So this is what you do, and I'm sure you know this already. I'm preaching to the converted here. But you're going to go on to some of the property sites. Possibly going to hop onto our remax.co.za website, and you're going to go and do a search and you're going to narrow it down. Or you're going to hop onto private property where they aggregate all the listings, and you're going to put in an area. You're going to put in some criteria, obviously, you know, within a range that you can afford. Or maybe it's the features like beds, baths, and beyonds, and you're going to put that in, and it's going to bring up a search list. Here's a tip for you. You may want to register on some of these sites, because new listings come on every single day. And unless you're one of those that hops onto the site every day, you can register yourself, and the site will actually alert you to any new listings in your price range and in your featured list range. So it'll narrow it down. It'll save you a whole bunch of time, and I recommend that you do that. So that's the search portion. You may also, and I would recommend actually, registering yourself, for want of a better term, or contacting a real estate agent, putting your name down and giving them the criteria of the home you're looking for. Why? Because when the market is hot, when homes are selling, and in these last 2 months, RE/MAX has sold a ton of property. We've had two record months in these last 2 months. So if that's the case, I would recommend that you put your name down with an agent, so that when they take a listing, even before it hits the website, which you think is the, or which most people see for the first time, they can contact you directly, set up an appointment, and get you to see the home. So get your foot in the door before the masses do, okay? So there's my tip on search. Three, use a trusted advisor. Note, I didn't say just use a real estate agent, because there's real estate agents, and there's real estate agents. Use a trusted advisor. a referral is always best. Someone that has used a real estate agent before, had a great experience, maybe it's a friend of yours. Generally, those referrals are the best source. I'm obviously going to promote RE/MAX here, and if you hop onto our RE/MAX website, you'll find a whole lot of trusted advisors. But generally, you're going to get from a referral the best source, right? So now you're working with someone and they're taking you through the different homes. Be honest with them, okay? When you're going to say, look, I'm looking for a three bed, two bath home in a particular suburb, and they're going to start to take you to house one and to house two and to house three and to house four, obviously after narrowing your search. And every time a new listing comes up, they're going to take you to another home. When you walk through that home, be honest with them. If it sucks, tell them, and be specific. Tell them you don't like the way the lounge looks. You don't like that there's not enough lighting. You don't like that it's not north facing. You don't like, tell them the things that you don't like. Don't feel bad. It's not their house, okay? So tell them why? Because otherwise they're gonna take you to other suckier houses that look just like that one. So make your life easy. When you go through the homes, let them know, even though it's three bed, two bath and has the features, let them know the things you like about the home that you saw, and more specifically the things you didn't like, so that they don't continue to take you to homes that may look similar. So that's my tip when it comes to when you start the actual process of house hunting and using a trusted advisor. Because if you don't, you know, then you're not gonna end up with the dream home that you'd hoped for. Okay, or you're not going to find it because they're going to keep taking you to the same homes. Right, so hopefully you go through this process, you've got your pre-qualification certificate, you've done your search, you've now checked a whole bunch of houses, and you've narrowed it down to something that you like and you actually want to put an offer in. Remember, you can now put an offer in with confidence because you've got your pre-qualification. You don't first have to run to the bank. So the offer can be complicated, okay? That's why they have conveyancing attorneys that assist in this process. But before we get to the actual offer to purchase, there are some determining factors to know when putting in the offer. Try and determine, and you'll know because you've been searching now for a while, and if not, talk to your agent, whether this is a buyer's market or a seller's market. You know, when there's lots of properties on the market for sale, well, generally, it's going to be a buyer's market. In other words, the more properties there are, the more competition between those properties, which means the prices are usually pegged down. The less properties that are on the market, meaning there aren't as many available, means those sellers can probably push their price up. And that's why you have this fluctuation in real estate on a continuous basis. So determine what it is so that you can be realistic when you put your offer in. And that's why I say using a trusted advisor is great, because they can help you with determining what a realistic offer on a property actually is. Again, know that someone with cash 9 out of 10 times wins the race simply because a seller lacks the certainty. So if you can't offer cash on a home, specifically if you're a first-time buyer, get a pre-qualification because it's almost as good. So that would be my advice. Then it comes to the actual contract itself. Again, can be complicated, and that's why I say conveyancing attorneys can definitely help you. And a trusted advisor, that real estate agent who knows what they're doing, will refer you to one if you don't have someone that you already use, because things that are going to get thrown at you are terms that you may not have heard before, like suspensive conditions and occupational rent and the fixtures and the fittings in the contract and levies and there's a whole bunch of stuff in that contract which needs to be read, needs to be understood, and needs to be explained in order for you to understand. Don't just enter into contracts and sign blank at the bottom. Make sure you know what you're signing. That's why you work with someone that you can trust, a conveyancing attorney that can assist, and or the trusted advisor that I spoke of. Step 5, show me the money. So step 5 is getting access to the finance, right? Now, all of a sudden, the seller goes, yes, I'm happy with the offer, let's move ahead. Now what? Well, now you've already got that pre-qualification. This should be a fairly simple process, but this is where I'm going to punt an originator again, and I want to show you a practical example on the screen behind me. So let's take Joe Bloggs, okay? Joe Bloggs just put that offer in, And now Better Bond is going to take that offer with the pre-qualification that they've got for you, and they're going to go and shop around. But Joe Blog says, listen, I'm going to try and first go to my own bank directly. So Joe goes to his own bank. The loan he's looking for is 1.2 million rand. Okay, it's a 20-year loan term, and he goes to his own bank. And this is a real life example, and don't read into the colors of the percentages. They don't represent any particular bank. But he goes to his own bank, and the bank says to him, listen, we can give you that loan, and the interest rate is going to be 10.56% based on your profile, Joe. Now, if Joe had stopped there, Joe would have missed out. But fortunately, Joe took his offer to purchase to Better Bond, and what Better Bond did was then took that same offer and shopped it around at the different home loan banks. And Bank A said, well, Joe, we can offer you 10%. Bank B said 11.25%. So that's not a great deal because it's more than what his own bank was offering. Bank C said 10.15%. Still better. But you know what's interesting is that Better Bond also goes to Joe's own bank, and his own bank through Better Bond came back with a rate of 9.75%. It doesn't sound like a big number. The difference between 10.56 and 9.75 seems minuscule. But work that out over 20 years, and Joe would have saved 155,000 rand over a 20-year period. You can buy a car with 155,000 rand. You can take the whole family around the world or to Disney World on 155,000 rand. And that's just on a loan of 1.2 million. That's why it's so crucial to shop around for a home loan. And you may as well use an originator like Better Bond who does that for you for free. Their service is for free. So a really important step here where you can save a whole lot of money. And then there's step six. The bank comes back with a with that offer, with a grant. They say, we're ready to finance you, Joe. And Joe is now becoming and has become the owner of the home. There's a whole bunch of technical things that happen in between, and municipal rates clearances and Beetle and electrical and etc. So you still need that trusted advisor to help you, right? And there's still a conveyancer that holds your hand through that whole process. But at some point, the house gets registered in your name and it's time to move. So schedule that move. And there's a bit of planning that has to happen behind that for those that haven't moved before. If you hop onto our site, again, it's on askremax.co.za. There's actually a checklist of things to check off when moving. So like, for example, for me, what was important, I wanna make sure when I get to the other side that the beer fridge is on and the TV is working. The other stuff can sort itself out, but for me, I'm just kidding. Or am I? I'm not sure if I'm really kidding. But there are a few things that have to get ticked off, right? Is the water connected? Is the DSTV connected? Have I ticked all the boxes, literally, of the boxes that I'm going to move? When is moving day? Have I scheduled it? Again, go on to remax.co.za. There's a checklist like that that will at least get you started on your journey. Excuse the pun. So I hope that made sense for you. I hope that some of those steps will assist you. I hope that some of the things I've shared with you will help to make the experience of purchasing a home a great experience for you. Again, if there's any questions that you have or anything else that you'd like to find out, we have a ream of information sitting on ask.remax.co.za. From blogs and videos and explainer videos down to a form that you can fill in where we'll contact you with any direct questions that you may have. Hope that was useful, and I look forward to enjoying the rest of this conference, and I hope you enjoy it too. Cheers.